An unexpected response to Russia expelling more than 700 employees from its Moscow embassy. Instead of threats like those he's levying in North Korea right now, he thanked Vladimir Putin. Here he goes.
I want to thank him because we're trying to cut down on payroll. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm very thankful that he let go of a large number of people because now we have a smaller payroll. There's no real reason for them to go back. So I greatly appreciate the fact that they've been able to cut our payroll for the United States. We'll save a lot of money.
Could not, these are 755, I believe, employees at the embassy. Many of them actually Russians who have been helping the U.S. now for many years.
It's really offensive to have a president who has a bad case of misplaced loyalties. He seems to miss no opportunity to speak well of Vladimir Putin and miss no opportunity to stand by people who support the work of the State Department. That's where his loyalties should be. This is a president who fundamentally does not understand that Putin is not some junior member of the Budget Committee. He's not an accountant. He is a very bad person who tried to hack American democracy. We've not heard a moaning word come out of this president's mouth with respect to what Vladimir Putin did to our democracy.
It does. I mean, for all the things he tweets about, he has said nothing about this expulsion by Vladimir Putin, except after being asked a question about it today, and then this is his response.
And it was clearly a prepared response. I mean, come on, he wanted to say that and then just come off out of nowhere. And we're not talking about compounds. We're talking about hundreds of American civil servants who just now apparently found out that they lost their jobs. I mean, I'm curious to see.
Well, a lot of them also were Russian personnel who worked.
Hundreds of them were Russian, hundreds of them were American as well. And I'm curious to see how Rex Tillerson reacts to this, because what I'm hearing from the State Department is that people are outraged by the president's comments on this. And again, it once again reiterates that the president cannot say anything remotely negative about
that. That is what's interesting. I mean, of all the times he could have said something.
Brief remark. I think the president was more in the spirit of shrugging it off than in praising. I don't think he was in any
way. This is one of those times where we're not supposed to take it literally.
But why do you think that he has never said anything negative about Vladimir Putin?
I think he has indicated through his support, again, of Secretary Tillerson, who has not made any secret of the fact that relations with Russia are at a very difficult point.
But the president has never said anything. I mean, he said stuff about Mitch McConnell, he said stuff about Jeff Sessions. He's never said anything negative about Vladimir Putin. Does that not surprise you?
He hasn't said anything negative about Li Jinping either, of China. I think he is, in his way, trying to treat Russia and China as the two other superpowers.
Every time the choice is between standing with an American or standing with Vladimir Putin, it is the State Department over and over with the same behavior from Donald Trump. He cannot say one ill word about Vladimir Putin. He has no problem saying it about practically everybody else.
That the reason he never says anything bad about Vladimir Putin is that Vladimir Putin helped him win the election?
I think that is categorically impossible.
Really?
Jeffrey. Yeah.
Though 11 intelligence agencies think that the Russians helped him win the election?
Well, number one, I don't think any of them have asserted that they helped the president win the election. Number two, I believe the correct number is 4 of the U.S. intelligence agencies have implied that the Russians have tried to hack into American election procedure process, which is hardly surprising, and none of which means, and I know we've discussed this exhaustively, but none of which means that the president in any way engaged them. And I think that's why he's been pretty sanguine about the whole thing. Again, he says he has treated the president of Russia and the president of China with a reasonable amount of diplomatic tact.
Let me tell you who Donald Trump says good things about. We heard him today talk about how decent a man Manafort is. We saw him over and over.
Well, he won Michael Manafort.
And we see him not say one bad word against Vladimir Putin despite what he does. You know who he's nice to? People who can hurt him. People who have information that can hurt him.
The president is in no way deferring to Vladimir Putin, just as he's not deferring to
what he did.
Humorous comment at the expense of jobs. And what was he doing having an hour-long conversation with the G20 instead of talking about, let's say, North Korea with other allies? Seriously, he's not supposed to speak with Vladimir Putin at the G20?
Now, right now, you're doing more TV now. Let me give you a pro tip. You do not make a joke or a comparison with the Holocaust. You do not quote the Nazis. You do not joke about rape, and you do not joke about American diplomats getting kicked out.
You've been watching the
TV, I'm telling you that that was not a joke. He is the president of the United States. And
what
we as Americans,
why are you talking to me about
we
that?
We should hold him to a standard.
Why is the president
because
you were joking about the Holocaust?
What he said as a joke about getting 755 diplomats, and it's false.
He wasn't.
You are calling it humorous and thus acceptable. If it was humorous, it was a lame, bad joke. And it was unacceptable.
I think the president is fully capable of conducting the foreign policy of the United States with the enormously talented work that Rex Tillerson does.
Which assumes that he's...
Okay.
That he's
that's what he does.
He's coordinating his policy with his Secretary of State.
But Cornell, we're going to talk about deference to Russia. Okay, the president has done nothing. No actions that he has taken have deferred to Russia.
He did want to set up a cybersecurity coalition with Russia and then walk that back.
On the other hand, in the previous administration, Russia actually grabbed Crimea from Ukraine, and President Obama did nothing. President Obama took our missile installations, right, out of our allies, out of Poland, out of Czech Republic. President Obama did that. President Trump has expressed nothing other than that. He will be resolute in defending the United States. President Obama, on the other hand,
has President Trump spoken out about Russian actions in Crimea?
He hasn't had
that. Speaking of President Obama, when we come back,